Welcome to DWBIADDA channel. Please subscribe for latest training videos.
Hi everyone. Today video tutorial is about performing an automation test in Maven using Selenium WebDriver. So we are going to see a demo of how a automation testing can be done in a Maven project. So the requirement will be Selenium WebDriver jar file for Selenium WebDriver test, and Eclipse ID where we are going to write our script, and exe Maven plugin, that is a Maven plugin which is used to execute the Selenium WebDriver script. So using these three only, we are going to test our web application using an automation testing tool, Selenium WebDriver. So here you can select any of your project and you can able to implement the following steps for performing an automation testing. So you can see here inside a project you are having a package, and here you are having the class like first program, second program, sample test, everything. So just create a new class. So you are going to do a Selenium test inside a normal Java class. So you can able to choose a class and give it as Selenium Maven test. Select your main method. Finish. In previous tutorial, I have explained about exe Maven plugin. The same concept we are going to use here to execute our Selenium script. Now, normally it is an automation testing used for web application. So if you want to test a web application, you need a browser and a valid URL. Only then you can able to test your web application. So now, if Selenium need to be supported, you have to add a Selenium jar file to your dependency. So in dependency, just add your Selenium jar file. So inside dependency, you give from Maven repository, select Selenium WebDriver dependency. So you have to give a version like 2.5, 3.1. Now search, you can see the dependency of Selenium WebDriver. Just copy the group ID, artifact ID in the version. Copy and paste inside the dependency. So now for your project, your Selenium WebDriver will get support. So in this jar only, all testing related methods and classes are available. Now you can see it has added, and just come to your program. First we need to write a script to open a browser. So I'm going to write a script for opening a Firefox browser. So I'm going to open the Google page. So just select www.google.com. So this is for to open a browser. To open a browser, we are going to use here a WebDriver class, or we can tell it as a WebDriver interface which is used to communicate with a browser. So give WebDriver, create an object for it. You can create any type of object, it is not a problem, with user defined. So I'm going to create it as B equal to new Firefox driver. And from here you can see it's showing some error. It is because you don't have any class. Save your project and then just keep on the class. You will get import Selenium package. And next you can choose for Firefox import Selenium. Once you are importing, it will open the Firefox driver when WebDriver script is loaded. And then using that WebDriver, using that browser only, every operation is done. So select that browser object dot get. Get method is used to get the URL to the browser. Now I am giving www.google.com URL. This is used to open the URL inside the Firefox browser. So next I am going to just test by getting the title and the URL, you know, just to show whether we have loaded to the correct URL and the correct title or not. So give it inside system.println, only then the result will be printed in your console. So if you want to use it for some other function, you don't want to give like this, but if you want to print it in console, you have to print in println method only. So here, if you want to give any input to your URL, like if you want to give any input to the web pages, you can use D stands for WebDriver object. So D dot find element by dot ID of. So you want to check for which element you have to give a entry text. So just come and inspect any of the element. You can see here search bar of your Google. Just keep the inspect element on the search bar. You can see the name or ID or class name. Choose anything. So here I am going to choose name and give whatever name that is specified there. So I am giving Q5 and import the Selenium package. Now dot send key. So give here Apache. Sorry, Selenium test. So once after opening your Google, it will get the title and print it in console. It will get the current URL and it will print it in console. And after that, it will search for Q5 element and type Selenium test. So after all completing, you will be getting Selenium testing using Maven is success. Whenever you are executing it, it will execute faster. So you have to see it in a minute the output. Not even a minute, in a seconds the output will be available. So now to your code, in previous tutorial I have said you how to add the exe Maven plugin. Just add the exe Maven plugin and change, instead of the class name, change it to Selenium Maven test, so that now the Selenium Maven test will execute. In goal give package space exe package exe colon java. So this is used to run your Java code. So inside Java code only we have embedded Selenium WebDriver script. Now execute it. You can see your Google page is loading, URL is getting loading, and it will take some time to give the send keys. So you can see here Google page loaded, www.google.com has also got loaded. And you can see here unable to inspect the element error. So that is nothing like whenever you are giving find element, you have to give the ID detail exactly as per in the web page. If not, else you will get an error. So come to your code. So here you can see this warning symbol that is executing because the error I have resolved. So here you can see Google www.google.com and the Selenium test success message. So you have to edit your script, the detail. Instead of, I have given Q5. So instead of that, give Q. So you can see in search bar also Selenium test have got printed. So this is how you have to do your Selenium test in Maven project. So here we are having so many methods, concept for testing a web application using Selenium WebDriver.
That we can see it in Selenium WebDriver tutorial. So this is how you need to execute your Maven project. So from the initial till the end, we have seen how to create a Maven project, how to manage the Maven project, and how to add the profile to your Maven project, and how dependency work, how repository works, and what all the steps involved in building and running the Maven project. So this is about a Maven project. There are a lot you can do it in a Maven project management. So like here in package, we are having only a 4 classes, and I've done 4 classes management, execution, everything. Whenever you're going into live, you will be having n number of classes, n number of files which have to be maintained in a Maven project. So according to that, you have to add the dependency, plugins, everything to your Maven POM XML file. The POM XML file you can design according to your project need. Thank you.